Guys, my name is Mukanya. I'm a CEO and founder at JTTales. Welcome on another video on destructuring in JavaScript. What is it? It's a JavaScript expression that allows us to unpack the value from array or object in a simple way. So like we always do when we create an array, so in order for us to access the elements, or we need to specify the index by using the square bracket. So we already have an array right here. So in order for us to display the value or the elements, we're gonna say delta square bracket, then we specify the index. So index 0, which will be the first element. Okay. So we have to do the same thing for the rest of the elements. There we say 1 and 2. So if I will refresh it, then here we go. All right. But this is kind of boring. So let's compare what we can come up with destructuring. So let's take the theory that we define, or do we describe what is destructuring, and then let's put it in practical. Let's create an example. The first example will be, we say let's, and then you specify the, since we work with array, we need to specify the square bracket. Then the first element is going to be referred as first name. The second one is last name. And the last one is age. Then we say equals to data. Then let's display the results. I'm just going to copy it and paste it. Us. And then we have age, this will be last name, age. Very good. So let's see the results. Well, we just have to refresh it, and bingo. All right. So let's see what will happen with example 2. So on example 2, what we can do is we need to say we have a first name and age. We do something like this. And then we create your array in here. Then say okay. Feature, comma, age will be. First name, then age. I'm just going to use plus to concatenate those values, those string value. So since this one will be an integer, so it will convert this integer to string. So I believe I mentioned it when we were working on some basic on JavaScript. So let's have a look. There we go. All right. Okay, so on the next example, we need to skip some elements. So I'm going to create an array. Okay, so let's say this will be our first name, then we're going to skip the second one. Then after that we have gender, there we have age equals to so that displays first name we have gender. Okay. So let's have a look. Because if it was not, then it's supposed to display undefined. Everything works. All right, so in order for us to skip a particular element from the array, you need to make use of a comma. All right, then let's get on. Let's create an example on assigning the remaining elements. Okay. So what we need to do is say let's have first name, surname. Yeah, we have to use three dots and then we say so that from the third element to the end of the array, there we have to give it a name. So the name will be so let's just say remaining. So it just you can give it any name that you want. So we have James, Mike, can provide gender will be name. Okay. To those statistics. Then they try to display the results. Consult of log, first name. Same name. Last one will be remaining. So I'm going to refresh our program to see what we have. Here we go. Okay. So the first name has the value of James, surname Mike, and then from the third all the way to the end, so it's actually pointed as an array, then the value, its value will be stored as an array. So from May to the end of the array, even though we add another value, it's still going to be the same thing. So let's say maybe students course, let's provide a course, let's say maybe software engineering. Okay, let's see what happens. Let us make sure that we save it. Okay. All right, good. So this one, this time it will be with a function. Let's create a function. Say function. data. And then the first one, it should return an array. So this will be maybe so we say net first name, gender, and age. Then we're just going to specify our function right here. Then we display the results. So the plug, we have first name, gender. And then the last one will be in H. Let's have a look. That is all going to be fine. Okay, I'm just going to comment this one. Okay, here we go. Still helps. Yeah. So our next example is about a default value. So what we're going to do, you're just going to create a variable as you usually do. Then you just have to make use of the equal sign, then you give it a default value. So this will be a default value that we give it to our key, our element, I mean. We are not talking about dictionary, this is we. Sorry about our element. So we need just set an array to so this will be the first element. So we can say maybe Peter. So this is an actual value that we have. And then surname would be maybe we can use Mike again. So it would be gender, and then the last it would be age. Okay, let's display it. So sort of logo, we have first name, just want to make something's wrong here. Now we have first name, then apart from that we have gender and age. It's great to see the output. So the default, if you can see, let's see what default value the user is still using the actual data. But if in case there was no value in here, then gems will be used. Okay, let me have a look. Just going to refresh it. Then we'll have gems. Just to avoid errors here. And then let's go to the next feature. And then for the next, it will be to swap the a value. So to sort a value, we can do this. Let's create first a variable. We have maybe our first name. We can say pizza. Then last name will be Mark. Okay. Now say let's and then we post our first name, comma, last name. And then when we're going to assign an array, then we just start with last name and then we end with first name. This is how we can swap the value. Now console.log first name. Then last one will be last name. Save it. Okay. So first name will have a value of Mike and last name will have a name of Peter. Has already been defined. Okay. I'm just going to remove this one from here. And then let's use maybe a variable. So they say username and surname. So wait a minute, refresh it. So now our username has the value of last name and surname has the value of first name. Okay. Then let's move to the next feature. Okay, so this will be retrieving a property value from the object. Okay. So this is going to be about the object. So let's create an object. We have our person teachers equals you name colon Joe surname be Mike. Yeah, we can say age colon 36. Then in order for us to retrieve the value of one of the properties, we need to use the variable name dot name. Or we can do this. Or we can use a square bracket. We specify the key or property value. So let's have a look. Alright, here we go. So now let's see how we're going to apply it on on our destructuring. So create an object, then use a destructuring. Okay. I'm going to use this one as an example. Then we have let's. On the array, we use a square bracket. Now, since this one is an object, we have to make use of a curly bracket. Alright. Then we specify name, surname, and age. Say equals to person teachers. discuss it. So I'm going to make this one as an example. One. Then console.log. I will get this by name. So, okay. Just let it as it is. Copy and paste. Surname and page. Let's refresh it. Bingo. Alright. I'm going to put my password here. And then I will move to example 2. So on example 2, we can do this. Let's name comma select. Say equals to name color narrator surname good. There was a console.log. There we have name. Last one will be server. Server work and then that refresh it. Yeah. Okay, so for the next one or the last one. Variable declare before, so the variable is declared before using it. To do, we're just going to do declare those variable and assign some value to it. And then it will be job, and then age will be 56. Well, we have to create an object. Then we post name and age. We say equals to the structure. We have name, name column. So those one will be used as a default venue. So this will be maybe Mike. And then age will be teaching. Okay. So now we can just display console.log. I will display name. And then the last one, we just have to display age. Okay. So after we've done that, we need to wrap everything inside of a parenthesis. Let me just wrap it inside the parenthesis. And then, we can refresh that one. So, then we have blank. Okay, we did that one. Alright. Thank you guys, so please subscribe, share, like this video. Bye.